This is our plane watching parrot. Joey's his name. Joey belongs to Belinda. Belinda's a friend of my daughter. Here comes that plane. I'm aboard. My pilot, Warner Lotz, the German madman, is coming down to check the field out for cows. There aren't any. In fact, you see there's no wheels. His landing gear isn't down, but he's trimming grass, and aboard is Buttons and Roy Russell. They might wet their pants on that one. But now his wheels are down. And we're coming in on a little grass strip that I hewed out of the jungle here. It's about 3,700 feet, but it's just fine for my Aztec. I bought this up in the States, and I fly in and out of the ranch of my house in San Jose. There's no plane here. Kind of a wet day, you see a little water on the runway. My son Dan picked me up, he's driving. Coming back down to our little compound, there's Buttons on top. Roy Russell in back. This is our little diesel Toyotas. We had three or four of these on the ranch. They were just fine for the country. We put in this road. This wasn't here when I first arrived. Nor was anything else. But we had a lot of fun cutting this little notch out of the jungle. Just finding this little spot of Goofy Foot waves that are beyond reproach from anywhere. My son Dan driving, Buttons in the middle, coming in from a trip to Golfito. This is our trip across to Golfito. This is our transportation for groceries and what have you when we're not flying in and out. Sawmill. We usually beach right here at the sawmill. Of course, the boat's ashore. Sun's going down. We'll wait for sunrise. Maybe there'll be some waves in the morning. Sometimes it's just flat calm here. Great diving, lobster, spear fishing, warm water, between 85 and 90 degrees. Clouds come in the evening, usually rains this time of year. Looks like it's after May or June, going into the rainy season. And at dawn, it's usually steaming. Little pelican patrol here, looking for fish in the waves. Down by the river, in front of the schoolhouse. He'll come back, run back up hill just like we do. Walk up the beach, jump in the water, ride it down a kilometer or two, have a sip of beer. The cantina is, you have to pass it. And it looks like there's barely rideable waves. But they crank along. They're fun. Roy Russell. Trying to make the best of this one. You got his slingshot on. You can tell how many years ago that was. Single fin. Long ride. Now he's even trying to nose ride his little shortboard. Of course, with those small noses, they don't nose ride too well. I spotted the camera. I forgot to comb his hair. Here's John on a Peruvian Paso, walking up the beach, Mount Apollo in the background, right there at the river. Small day. These horses are right, like riding a Ferrari. Look at his head isn't bouncing, his shoulders aren't moving. John Aiken, we call him Juan Caballo because he liked the horses. We had a lot of these Peruvian Pasos. They were fun riding down there. And Mr. Buttons, ready to hit the waves. Just getting in the water. Oh, you might as well just ride this thing backside. Get a little shower. Right now, I got overhead a little bit, it looks like. Actually got a little bit of a tube here. In fact, he should have gotten more because he got eaten up by that one. The thing about these waves, you just got to keep going and going because that's probably his mistake by cutting back. He'll probably get eaten up if I know anything about this wave. He must have. Because now we're into Roy Russell again. Guys had a lot of fun down there. You can see Pavone's hasn't got any crowd whatsoever. I guess it's a different story nowadays. We more or less kept this little spot quiet for years and years. I invited a few of these guys down and they appreciated the fact that there wasn't anyone down there surfing. And they were pretty much vowed to secrecy. If anyone saw the films, we wouldn't tell exactly where it was. The Surfer magazine and other surfing magazines wouldn't divulge the location of the shots they took here. I'd see them periodically in some of the magazines. They'd call it someplace else. But we kept it pretty quiet for about 20 years. Well, it looks like there's three guys in the water there anyway, doesn't it? That's a crowd in those days. Rory has a t-shirt on today, riding that slingshot, being exposed. The sun is hot there, burnt Jeff, so he had to keep that shirt on to keep the sun on. These guys just got wave after wave after wave. Buttons would say, gee, bro, my back leg gets so sore going off the lip so much. You'll notice it. As loose as he looks here, you see him even get looser as the time goes on. He claims that surfing Pavone's for a week is like surfing 2 or 3 months in Hawaii, because you get so much footage out of each wave and there's no one there to you drop in front of you, or knowing they have to go around. A week down there is like a month or two anywhere else surfing, because the machine just keeps grinding them out. Surfing into the little bay at the cantina past the schoolhouse here. You can ride her all the way to the beach if you want. Step off. Walk up the beach. Grab a beer at the cantina. Walk another half a kilometer or so up to the river. Paddle out about 50 yards. Get another wave. And go again. Imagine this guy doing this on a single fin 20 years ago. Nothing like the guys are doing now. There's a cantina in the background. Someone heading up the beach. Button said this is the best surfing trip he'd ever been on. Here's one of our workers. Good guy with a machete. Put him on the fence line, he'd work all day long swinging that machete. Of course, he liked to drink too. He ended up spending his weekly wages right there in the cantina. Every once in a while, we'd send a dog out to get us a pig so we can have a little party. Clue of the pig. There he is. We got him on the bench now. Fire's going. We heat up the rocks. The hole's already dug. We sew up the banana leaves, yams, onions, apples, all the other goodies you put in. Here's those spider wells getting ready for a day of shooting. A lot of waves, wave after wave. Those are the good old days. Wave after wave. Looks like Weaver's in the water here, shooting from his water housing. He swims out, gets right in the edge, right in front of the cantina. Of course, they all know he's filming, so they like to take off right in front of him there now. There's a spear job if I ever seen one. Looks like Dan. Buttons, then Rory. Another Rory story. It looks like he's keeping that shirt on. Oh no, he hasn't got it on there. He must be brave. At least he's got semi-long pants on today. Dropped the slingshot in the cantina beer mug or something. Little boards looked like they had real fat noses and kind of slowed them down a little bit at that time. You'd have to walk up in a nose to get them to go or surf way forward, and they're so wide it looks like they're a little bit slow. But they sure could do 360s in them. Another shirt day, Rory story. That's the Starbolt brand of boards he was riding for Lightning Bolt then. He changed his t-shirt. You can see this isn't all the same day. He's feeling his oats here. Let's start off with a 360. Switch foot. That back leg used to get sore. So we'll ride it front side for a while. Now that leg isn't used to it, so we might as well go back to goofy foot. Yeah, it's a rough day, boys. Rough day at the office. Spider's always playing with some sea snake or something here. He fascinated. Here's a caterpillar. Poor little thing. Look at this big brute come by and step on it. Who is that? Oh, I might have known it's Spider Wells. What a brute. Gonna climb a mountain. Rory got brave and took his t-shirt off today. Maybe because Weaver's in the water. He's in a little pocket there. Looks like it's getting a little more size to it here. What that woman's been doing to me. I'm gonna buy a chicken now. As far as I can. Ain't I never coming back. Back up. Later in the day, the wind always starts blowing in the afternoon. In the morning, it's always glassy. So you can see that this is later in the afternoon. Look at the egotism of this guy. Here he is on the cover of Surfer magazine, and then he peeks out around there like, oh, it's really nothing, bro. This is an afternoon shot. The sun's going down. Later in the year, it starts raining more and more in the afternoon and earlier in the day. By now, it's fully pouring around July, August, September. Okay, it's a new day. In fact, it's a new year. This is 1981, and we're coming out from Golfito. In a little boat I bought for fishing here. I got the boards on the nose. Brought a couple of my surfing buddies and a couple of my fishing buddies. The ones with the rods and reels are fishermen. And the guys sitting around like they're about something and giving me the finger, those are surfers. Spider's fascinated over the bugs here. Sit here and look at all the bugs and insects that come out of this jungle. Boy, when you get back in there, there's lots of big, beautiful butterflies. Oh, there it is. There's a big cockroach. And one of these guys hit Spider the night before in the ear, and he thought someone was attacking him. Flew right in the window. But jumped out of his shorts. Here's my son and... Who is it? I can't tell. This pelican got sick on the way out, and he puked, if you notice here. It's another day and another ride. Here's Dan Jr. Of course, Dan surfed this wave so much, he's got it pretty well wired. He's just going to stay in the pocket almost all the way. Not going to let it get ahead of him too far or behind him too far. He'll ride from the river there down to the cantina and then walk up the beach. Take another one. Just like you're supposed to. Tell when he's going around the corner of the cantina right there into the bay. Pretty long ride. He's really in the distance here. Same thing on the next wave. Stay right in the pocket. The ones that he's riding, he stays in that outside rubber mouth way. They're a little better size outside, so he looks like he's pulling out to make a paddle. He stays a little bit a larger wave. Now it's getting a little smaller, so he's about ready to get out of here again. It's a great wave to learn on, especially when you try all your little hot dog trips on this one. The guys now surfing, they'll get aerials, spins, and you name it. Of course, it was unheard of back here in the 80s, early 80s. He saw something there he didn't like. But he's going to ride her to the beach anyway. He didn't want to paddle. Here's your button again. He's on the express top half of this one. I guess he doesn't want to get left behind. Well, that's why right there. Dan had his wave pretty well wired. Even he started doing his 360s there. Watching buttons do him so easy. He got right into it. On a small day like this, you had to really get on your bicycle to make the end of it because didn't have enough size to really let you get the whole length of the wave unless you're really on the bike. That's why Button was bouncing to get up from speed. I think if they had a little better boards or a narrower nose, I think they could have done a lot better. But, look at the fish and water in this wave. Great fishing there. Just anytime you want them, you can go out and get them. Now here's a girl looking to take a swim, but she's checking both ends of the beach out to see if there's anyone looking because she has to change into her bathing dress. Didn't see anyone there. So off it comes. Spider's up there in the weeds with the camera. Put her bathing dress over. And watch this. When she turns around, she spots him. Oh, she sees him up there. Yep, that's a guy up there. Well, that's okay. I'm covered. Besides that, there's a guy here on the beach. But anyway, she's all ready for her swim now. I'm gonna shake the debris out of her dress. She's a very coordinated lady here in the water, as you can see. That one almost knocked her over. Another evening, another time shot. The great Spider Wells. Time shots. Another day, another rider. This is Bud Lamas from Huntington Beach. He was down there just for a short time. He never did get any real good waves, but he had a few days like this. You can see him at Huntington still thrashing around out there. He's a good old rider. He loved it down here. Brief visit. That's him. You can always tell him. He splashes it on the cutback. It's always a big splash out. Oh, he even learned how to do some S-turns. U-turns. Those people in the water that he just passed. Here's C.W. Chris Wood and his buddy from Huntington. Dan Jr. in a small wave. He had to get on his hands and knees on this one to get it overhead. Looks like they're just right for cutting donuts, so. Another Bud Lamas. Bud Lamas and C-Dub came down together. Shame they didn't have any overhead surf while they were here. But they enjoyed it anyway. Nice and glassy, a little bit bumpy, but not a bad ride. Single fin, nose rides in those little boards with the single fin really slowed it down. Look at Dan, he's getting in a real claro. You can see how clean this water is. You could get into your hair and stuff and then it just felt like you shampooed and cream rinsed it. God, your hair felt good after getting on your whole body. No scale, no nothing. See the debris that looks like it's been raining. The water's a little milkier looking. Some debris in the water. Here's Chris Wood. Flex your muscles, Chris. Oop, there's some debris. It's in the surf line. You can hang a skeg on it. And he goes, up, saw it, scared the hell out of him. Looks like it's getting overhead here, almost. Chris is still there, but I don't see Bud Lamas after this. He must have went home. This must be a different day. Sure it is, because it is overhead now. Little tube. Nice little ride. A long one is that. Look at that wave outside. Hardly anyone in any of these waves. The big one outside is all by itself. And another one. And another one. And another one. Who's this now. This is John Aiken. He was on the horse earlier at Juan Caballo. Nice wave. John's been down there a long time. He knows how to stay out of the throttle of that lip. Yeah, John had his bottom turned down. You get down there and turn right on the bottom and go back up that thing. John didn't waste any time, though. He liked to go out there when it was good. To my people on the side. This looks like Roy Russell, not John. It is the Roy story. That little window of the ocean there, looking over towards Golfito. All these are almendro trees on the beach. Ah, we got someone on the outside wave also. Spider must be taking pictures from the schoolhouse in this one. He'll pass right by the cantina here. No, didn't go in. Tom O'Neill. This is Tom O'Neill. He's on a kneeboard. He was down for a while. Tom planted a whole bunch of coconuts along the beaches for me. He planted coconuts all day long. Besides all the people that were available for work, guys would come down and do a little work also. They like to surf. Tom O'Neill's from the famous surfmaker family, O'Neill Wetsuits. Looks like a bigger day. There's someone inside, and the wave outside a lot bigger. And one outside that even bigger. I guarantee you today these waves aren't going to waste. There's a number of people in the water. See how that grinder keeps putting out those waves? Good thing this guy on the inside is getting this one. The ones on the outside, they eat them up. There you can barely see a guy in the water. It's a better day. Long wave, long, long wave when they're this size. Well over a kilometer. Get down past the schoolhouse, close to 2 kilometers. Looks like he's going for the schoolhouse. You have to catch the tide just right to do those, from the river to the school. One thing about it though, you have to just keep going. Otherwise you get chewed up, just like this. Bad we didn't get some pictures of Pat. He took a gun or two down there. He's kind of modest. He doesn't like anyone. He won't go in the water when people are shooting pictures sometimes. That's why you see very few pictures of him. Pat Kern. I made his first board for him, a kind of a semi-gun. His son turned into a great surfer. Both of them did. Both Joey and Tom. Of course, Morris Tommy, a couple times world champion. That she's a black magic woman. She's trying to make a devil. But he's surfing for local motion. Don't turn your back on the baby. Don't turn your back on the baby. I don't think they ever got any of this film. Yes, don't turn your back on the baby. I was too paranoid of getting it out. We kept it under wraps for years. Back leg got tired. Joey, you're gonna face some music here. Now he'll go backside again. Long wave. In fact, he's got his finger up there. He feels this was the longest wave he ever got. Our little diesel jeeps would go across the Rio Claro with no problem. Sometimes we'd get a little deeper than that. We'd have to open up the door on the side and let the water out in the car. You see this little, like cotton balls floating, coming down the Rio Claro? Those are seeds from the balsa wood tree. We've got lots of balsa wood tree along this coastline. At the sawmill, I cut a bunch of nice balsa, really lightweight balsa. We learned how to cut which trees to cut. The younger, the better. The real young trees are about 14 inches in diameter. It's a real rare shot where you find steam or fog coming off the water to Rio Claro. And a squadron of RAF fighter pilots coming through here, looking like trying to play like they're a wave. Now, if you watch them, you'll see the wave come across. Here comes one. There's a wave. There's another wave. There's another wave. And a famous time lapse. The Spider Wells evening time lapse. And that's the end. See the candle, and when the wind blows it out, we're all through for 1981. That's Pafonis. End of story.